Imagine a world where humanity ventures into the last untouched wilderness on Earth, miles beneath the ocean's surface. In this abyss lies unimaginable treasures and terrifying consequences. Welcome to the controversial world of deep-sea mining, Earth's true final frontier. We often dream of colonizing Mars, but the real final frontier isn't in space, it's here on Earth. Cloaked in perpetual darkness, under crushing pressure, the deep sea is home to alien-like life forms, uncharted ecosystems, and minerals worth trillions. But as land-based resources dwindle and our hunger for rare earth elements grows, humanity has set its sights on this ancient, silent world. At the heart of deep-sea mining are three main treasures: polymetallic nodules, potato-sized rocks rich in nickel, cobalt, and manganese, cobalt-rich crusts coatings on underwater mountains, seafloor massive sulfides, metal-rich deposits formed at hydrothermal vents. To reach them, advanced robotic submersibles scour the seafloor designed to scoop, grind, and vacuum minerals from the deep. The stakes, trillions of dollars in untapped resources. Nations like China, Japan, and the US, along with powerful corporations, are racing to stake their claim beneath the waves. But the deep ocean is not just a vault of minerals, it's a fragile world. Many of its creatures grow at an impossibly slow pace, taking centuries to recover if they ever do. Mining could unleash devastating effects: sediment plumes smothering life for miles, noise pollution disrupting communication in whales and other species, entire habitats destroyed before we've even discovered them. The truth is, we barely understand the deep sea, and once it's gone, we may never get it back. Who decides the fate of the deep ocean? Enter the International Seabed Authority, the global body tasked with regulating deep-sea mining. But debates rage on. Should we move forward or call for a moratorium until science catches up? Some argue mining is essential for clean energy technologies, powering electric cars and renewable grids. Others say we risk trading one environmental disaster for another. There may be another path. By investing in advanced recycling, reducing waste, and developing alternative materials, we could meet our needs without sacrificing Earth's last untouched wilderness. The ethical question is clear. Should humanity exploit every corner of our planet or preserve some places as they are, forever? The legacy we leave beneath the waves will echo for generations. The choice is ours. If this story sparked something in you, share it. Raise awareness. Because the future of our oceans and maybe our planet depends on what we choose to do next.